Oh hi, are you looking for a wide angle lens for vlogging? Is your lens wide enough? What's the best lens for vlogging setup? Well, there's so many questions about what's the best lens to buy for vlogging. Well, I might have an answer for that. And here, I have the Rokinon 12mm autofocus with an aperture of f2 for Sony E-mount. Now first, here's an interesting fact about this lens. This lens is basically identical to the Samyang 12mm f2. It's just rebranded as Rokinon here in the US for marketing purposes. As you can see here, it says technology by Samyang Optics. So just in case if you're buying a wide angle lens and these two brands pops out, that's because they are actually the same. So this is an ultra wide angle lens, which is great for vlogging or an astrophotography if you are into that. I think this lens is perfect for an APS-C sensor size camera for vlogging, even with its crop factor, which makes this 12mm turns into 18mm on a full frame equivalent. It still gives you a decent amount of field of view at your arm's length. This lens is very small and light. It's well built of mostly plastic and glass. It has a metal ring mount and an electronic connectors for the autofocus motors and a rubber gasket to its side for weather sealing. It has a wide focus ring that has a micro pattern feel to it, and it feels very smooth when you're turning the focus ring. I like the matte finish to it and that red color ring design, and it only weighs 225 grams on my scale, which is a really great pair on the APC camera for a very light vlogging setup, and it looks great on the A6000 series cameras. It has a 62mm filter thread mount for any filters, such as ND filters that you wanna screw in front of the lens. And on the lens, it says it has a minimal focus distance of 0.2 meters or 0.66 feet, which allows you to get closer to your subject and get that unique shot. When you open the box, it comes with lens hood, but the downside of that, you can't reverse thread it for storage, so I keep that aside and not use it, for I use a variable ND filters anyways. Now, I hate to say this, but for me, this lens does feels like a cheap lens. And speaking of that, I only got this lens on sale for $199 on Amazon. Now, its regular price tag is around $400, and if I have to say $400 for what this lens is, it's a little bit much. So I recommend if you're planning to buy or get one of these, just wait until it goes on sale again or buy it used for a much cheaper price. So anyways, let's go and test this baby out and compare it to my Sigma 16mm and the Sony 18-105 and see how it competes for vlogging. Now, I'm not gonna go in depth test review on this one and nitpicking to the smallest pixel size on this lens. But just coming from a consumer standpoint who wants a wide angle lens for practical use such as vlogging and YouTube content creating. Because in reality, nobody's going to notice the pixel size and the chromatic aberration when they're watching your video. I mean, who does that? Okay, fine, it's Gerald Undone, but nobody else is Gerald Undone, okay? All right, so here we are for our vlogging test. Right now we are on the Sony 18-105 f4 at its widest, 18mm, so in full frame equivalent with a 1.5 crop factor. You're looking at a 27-28mm on full frame equivalent. So how is it looking? So this is at arm's length. So I have fully extended my arm, so this is how you get. It's not bad, it's a little tight, but yeah, this is what you get on the Sony 18mm. Alright, so now you're looking at the Sigma 16mm 1.4. It is a 24mm equivalent to a full frame with a 1.5 crop factor of the Sony A6400. And how's it looking? Is it good? How's that creamy blurry background? It's really nice when you have that stop down to 1.4. So yep, so you're looking at Sigma 16mm 1.4. Now let's switch to the Rokinon.
Alright, so finally we are on the Rokinon or Samyang 12mm f2. On a full frame equivalent, you are looking at 18mm. So definitely we have a wider field of view here, and you can show more of your background. You have that more breathing space when you're vlogging. And at f2, it has a decent background blur. It's not as creamy as the Sigma 16mm, but it's pretty decent. I dig it. I like this lens actually. It's very light, and at arm's length, it's not too heavy. So you can vlog like this without getting your arms tired easily. So yeah, all right.
So overall, this lens is actually great to have if you're looking for an affordable, lightweight vlogging or wide angle lens on your APS-C camera. It's pretty decent for video and photos. Plus, for its compact size and weight, it's great for traveling. Definitely be bringing this with me on my next travel. And you can actually use a small gimbals on this setup, such as the Zhiyun Crane M2 for a stabilized shot. Alright, so that's it for today's video. I hope you find it useful. Please give this video a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. And click that bell icon so you won't miss any of my videos. Until then, I'll see you in the next one. Ciao!